Documented information, this is an interesting one. It sometimes gets people a little bit worked up, but it's not as bad as it initially sounds. If you're currently running a management system, you probably recognise this type of structure in terms of documentation. So at the top you've got a policy, underneath that you've got manual, underneath that you have a set of procedures, and then you've got a lot of records and forms. Okay. Does that look pretty familiar to people? Okay. Well, what guys back at ISO decided is they want to give you a lot more freedom in terms of the documentation that you choose to hold and the format that you choose to hold it in. Okay. So they sat down and had a bit of a think and thought, okay, records and forms, we won't refer to those anymore. We'll get rid of that reference. Procedures, actually, we won't bother referencing procedures anymore. We won't talk about procedures. Quality manuals, environmental manuals, they just sit on the shelf getting dusty. We'll get rid of those. And then I thought, oh gosh, that's a bit drastic. All we're left with now is a requirement for policy. What can we do? I know what we'll do. We'll create something called documented information. The thing about documented information is throughout the various standards, you'll see references to retaining or maintaining documented information. Where you see a reference to retaining, it's essentially a request to hold a record. And where you see maintaining, it's essentially a request to establish a procedure or a process. As I mentioned before, documented information is now media agnostic. So literally, if you want to hold it in a computer system, in a Word document, you can. If you want to hold your evidence in a spreadsheet, you can. If you want to hold it in a database, you can. If you want to tattoo it on somebody's back, you can. All of this is absolutely fine. It's up to the organisation to choose how it wishes to hold the required information. A lot of organisations have invested a lot of time and effort in producing their procedures. You don't have to throw them out if you don't want to. Okay, they are documented information. If they're useful and they're working for you, you're entitled to keep them. That's absolutely. Nothing in the standards say they've got to go.